What up, all you soufflées out there? This is Nat from 303. Right now, you're watching AMBY.
Hey everyone, it's Alicia, and I would like to welcome you to my Warped Tour interview here in Toronto with 303.
What's happening?
How are you?
How are you?
I'm fantastic, yeah. Having a good day so far?
Oh my god, we got here in Toronto, and it's beautiful. It's I actually spent a couple years living here, so it was nice to come home. I was just saying, I went and sat in the Bellwoods Park with white jeans, which is a bad idea.
You have evidence now.
Yeah, my butt is looking grass-stained. And brown.
Is that somewhere that you like going whenever you come back?
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's so peaceful.
It's peaceful and it's nice, and it's just nice to be able to sit in the park with some friends and just and catch up and stuff. And it's such a great city here, and you can see the whole world in the day. And it's true. It's so multicultural and wonderful here.
Yeah. Well, for Warped Tour, for a lot of kids, it's actually their first concert or festival. Yeah. So for you, what was that first show?
Oh, I think I've been going to shows pretty much since the cradle. My parents' friends were in bands, so I remember going to shows and literally falling asleep at shows because I was so
really?
Young I couldn't stay awake. So it's probably why I can't hear very well these days, but it's all good. It's worth it.
They posted a photograph on Instagram not too long ago from Warped Tour, yep. And it caught my eye because the caption was, "We're men. Men in tights."
Yeah.
So why did you feel like posting that up?
Because we're children of the 90s. That was a great movie. Oscars snubbed it. I don't know why. The Robin Hood Men in Tights. You ever see that one?
Yeah.
It's a great movie.
It's a great movie.
It really brings a tear to your eyes.
I like how that was the caption you chose, because I couldn't tell because it was a black and white photograph, too. I'm like, are those leggings, tight jeans? Wasn't sure.
I don't know. Actually, Sean wrote that, and I'm like asking myself why he did it as well. Yeah, but hey, he did it. So.
When you think back to other fashion fads that you went through when you were growing up, do any stick out to you? Other ones that you're super stoked on or a little bit embarrassed of?
No, not even embarrassed. I wore JNCOs.
Okay.
But I had like the JNCOs are like the really baggy 90s pants.
Yeah.
I wore those in middle school, but I had like the kind of conservative ones that were corduroy.
Oh, nice.
And not quite as
baggy. You found that balance.
Yeah. So I guess I just kind of half-assed it. I should have gone full JNCO.
Yeah, you read a little bit?
I had a bowl cut, which was sick. I should go back to that.
Well, taken from your latest record release, Night Sports, I have to say, my dick. Great song.
Oh, thank you.
I can't hear that
thank
song
you.
And just not crack
thank
up.
You, yeah.
Now, I'm wondering, though, as far as being in the studio goes, is it really hard to kind of keep it together and just not laugh? I imagine that it's just laughing the whole time.
You know, that was one of the things I think that keyed us into, like, the fact that song was going to be fun to listen to and hopefully fun to perform and fun for people to see. I think for us, it's always been a central thing, like having fun, and whether it's laughing about something, you know, that's overtly funny, or just having fun making something, that's like the most important thing for us.
Mm-hmm. And now Want is going on a decade.
It
so
is.
So is that a little bit surreal to you?
It
to think,
is.
Like, hey, this actually came out that long back.
Yeah, it's super surreal. And, you know, we got a lot of people coming out here and saying, oh, I've been listening to stuff for 10 years, ever since I was in middle school, or you guys, like, you know, kind of were iconic to my childhood. It's amazing. Yeah, and it's super flattering, and we're going to plan some fun stuff for the fall around that.
I know they're actually playing a lot of tunes off of the record now, too, just in celebration.
Yeah.
So revisiting those must be nice.
Yeah, it is. And we kind of do all of our sets as like a kind of a greatest hits anyways, but really packing it into a 30-minute set on Warped Tour has been challenging, but it's been really fun to be able to kind of hit all that stuff and hopefully kind of give people a taste of that, of the old stuff as well as a little bit of the new stuff.
When you think back to the older stuff, kind of the beginning, what are some of the first memories that come to mind?
Oh my God. Just being so sweaty and, you know, our music was all about just having fun and trying to bring energy, fun, and a little bit of edge to what we were doing and make sure that it was inclusive for everyone. So it was really that, just like from rock and house parties at the University of Colorado in Boulder to kind of extrapolating that to bigger venues. It was always about that. And we're very fortunate. Yeah. That we're able to say it's still that way. Yeah.
Well, here on the site, we not only interview musicians, but also wrestlers.
Okay.
So if you were to have that in-ring gimmick or persona, what would it be?
I would bake a souffle and then, take the souffle and slam it in the opponent's face.
Okay. Hot. Or would the thing with the souffle is
like, it's like when you go to the restaurant, you gotta order it almost like before you order your main dish, because it takes a while So I would have to do some pre-production and pre-planning to be able to time the souffle perfectly, okay. So that it's not too hot. You don't want to scald the competition. Yeah. You just want to souffle.
Get him a little good. Yeah, souffle man.
Be, well, I'm half French, and so it's like Monsieur Souffle, maybe.
Mr. Souffle, I like it.
Monsieur.
Monsieur. Monsieur Souffle. We'll just wrap things up. Yeah. I do want to leave things.
That could be one of my fans. Rap monikers. Yeah,
yes. Like that. Or even a song title.
Monsieur Souffle.
Yeah.
That's good.
I'm feeling it.
That's good. That's really good. I'm going to forget it in 5 minutes. So I should probably write it down.
I'll tweet it down.
Okay, please. Please do. Please do. Please do. Please do.
Is there anything you want to say to all of your fans who leave you in just to wrap things
up? We want to say, I mean, it's been amazing to be on this Warped Tour, just like every other one, but it's... It's amazing just to come out and, you know, be able to rock a show and kind of hype up a party every day. That's what we love doing, and we're privileged in that people come out and you know, with the same spirit. So it's been a pleasure. And Monsieur Souffle wants to thank every little souffle out there.
I feel like you're gonna really embrace this.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah. It's done. It's over. Today's all about souffle, you know. Well, you gotta seize the souffle.
Seize the moment, right? Yeah. Thank you for joining me.
Thank you for having
me. Oh, it's my pleasure.
Pleasure.
And remember to everyone viewing.
What's my move? What's the souffle move? We'll do that on the next.
Yeah, next
on the follow
time,
up. Next time we come through Toronto.
Awesome. Thank you for watching.
And I'll bake a souffle.
Please.
Okay. Thank you.